Laudator Jesus Christus. Welcome to the live broadcast from the Shrine of El Señor de los Milagros for the celebration of prayer during the day with women religious and contemplative institutes. About 500 Peruvian religious will participate in this event with the Holy Father. For Vatican News, I am Sister Bernadette, and with me today again is Deacon Cesar. Welcome.
Thank you, Sister Bernadette.
A welcome to all of you who are joining us around the world through various channels of Vatican News, and those of you joining us through CBS News, Shalom World TV, EWTN, Salt and Light, Radio Maria, and Catholic TV, as well as through radio or internet. Welcome to all of you. As we see, the Holy Father has already entered the shrine and is being greeted by the many religious who are here present. This shrine is located in the historic center of Lima and is dedicated to the cult of the patron of Peru, the Lord of Miracles. The shrine is run by the Discalced Carmelite Nazarenes. The Lord of the Miracles is a 17th century wall painting, which we will most likely see, and it represents Christ's crucifixion. It has survived several earthquakes. And because it has survived earthquakes, it has become the object of devotion of the Peruvian Catholic community. There are numerous healings and graces attributed to this painting, which is why it has the name Lord of Miracles. After a greeting today by the Mother Superior, we will join the sisters in daytime prayer. Our Holy Father has taken his seat.
Priora de este monasterio de Nazarenas Carmelitas Descalzas, con profundo gozo en el corazón.
Holy Father, we welcome you to this monastery.
Nos acercamos a ti, Carmelitas contemplativas, para ofrecerte el testimonio.
We want to offer you the testimony of love of our consolation.
Contemplativas. Que antes que nada les digo,
we're contemplatives.
Bienaventurado, Padre nuestro. Hace poco tiempo, hace unos 50 años,
about 50 years ago,
el monasterio de Nazarenas Carmelitas,
this monastery of the Carmelites,
convento de Lima, Carmelitas Descalzas. A esta hermosa tierra.
Came to this beautiful land.
Desde entonces,
since then,
mi corazón y mi alma se mueven por el Señor de los Milagros.
My heart and my soul are moved by the Lord of the Miracles.
A derramar tantas gracias.
The Lord who came to this land to pour so many graces in this land. Lord of the Miracles, Señor de los Milagros, bless our land, bless our Holy Father in these months of so much work, in the cross, in the meditation of the Word, and in the Eucharist.
Somos misioneras.
We are missionaries of a contemplation. And in the silence of our hearts, we walk. We walk with the help of our Lord. We walk under our Pope and our bishops,
La Santa Madre Teresa de Jesús.
Madre Teresa of Jesus.
400 años.
Already 400 years ago.
Hablaba de esta manera.
She talked in this way.
Está ardiendo el mundo.
The world is burning.
Sentenciar a Cristo, pues le hacen mil testimonios. Pero nosotros somos los misioneros de la esperanza.
We are the missionaries of hope.
Metidas ahí en una celdita.
The missionaries are in a cell.
Ahí junto al Señor.
There, close to our Lord. We pray, we sanctify. Thank you, Lord, for you have come. Thank you for being with us. Thank you because you're going to stay with us. Among your children, your Peruvian children, they thank you for coming. We want to continue the celebration with you. Welcome to Peru.
Santo Padre,
Holy Father,
Francisco.
Pope Francis.
Sisters now offering their gifts to the Holy Father.
Dios mío, ven en mi auxilio. Gloria al Padre, y al Hijo, y al Espíritu Santo.
And so daytime prayer begins, and now the hymn, a hymn to the Holy Spirit, will be intoned. And now we begin the psalmody for daytime prayer with the antiphon, I called to the Lord in my distress, and he heard me. Alleluia. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his love endures forever. Let the sons of Israel say, his love endures forever. Let the sons of Aaron say, his love endures forever. Let those who fear the Lord say, his love endures forever. I called to the Lord in my distress. He answered and freed me. The Lord is at my side. I do not fear. What can man do against me? The Lord is at my side as my helper. I shall look down on my foes. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in men. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in princes.
The Lord's right hand has raised me up. Alleluia. The nations all encompass me. In the Lord's name I crush them. They compass me about. In the Lord's name I crush them. They compass me about like bees. They blaze like a fire among thorns. In the Lord's name I crush them. I was hard-pressed and was fallen, but the Lord came to help me. The Lord is my strength and my song. He is my Savior. There are shouts of joy and victory in the tents of the just. The Lord's right hand has triumphed. His right hand raised me up. The Lord's right hand has triumphed. I shall not die, I shall live and recount his deeds. I was punished by the Lord, but not doomed to die.
Thank you.
The Lord God is our light. Alleluia. Open to me the gates of holiness. I will enter and give thanks. This is the Lord's own gate, where the just may enter. I will thank you, for you have answered, and you are my Savior. The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. This is the work of the Lord, a marvel in our eyes. This day was made by the Lord. We rejoice and are glad. O Lord, grant us salvation. O Lord, grant success. Blessed in the name of the Lord is he who comes. We bless you from the house of the Lord. The Lord God is our light. Forward in procession with branches, even to the altar. You are my God. I thank you. My God, I praise you. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his love endures forever.
Espíritu de esclavitud, para recaer otra vez en el temor.
You did not receive the spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you have received the spirit of sonship. When we cry, Abba, Father, it is the Spirit himself bearing witness with our spirit that we are children of God. Thank you.
Queridas hermanas de los diversos monasterios de vida contemplativa.
Dear sisters from different monasteries of contemplative life. How good it is to be here in this shrine of the Lord of Miracles, visited so often by Peruvians, to ask His grace so that He would show us His closeness and mercy. He is the light that guides, that illumines us with His divine love. Seeing you here, I get the impression that you took advantage of this visit to get out for some fresh air.
Gracias, Madre Soledad, por sus palabras de bienvenida.
Mother Soledad, I thank you for your words of welcome, and I thank you all for who, from the silence of the cloister, walk ever by my side.
Desde aquí mandar un saludo a mis cuatro carmelos de Buenos Aires.
From here, I want to send a greeting to my four Carmelites in Buenos Aires, to the four monasteries in Buenos Aires.
Ante el Señor de los Milagros, porque ellas me acompañaron en mi ministerio en aquella diócesis.
They accompanied me in my ministry in that diocese.
Para que el Señor las bendiga. No se ponen celosas, ¿no? Escuchamos las palabras de San Pablo recordándonos que hemos recibido el Espíritu.
We have listened to the words of St. Paul and been reminded that we have received the Spirit of filial adoption that makes us children of God.
El gozo de sabernos hijos. Esta es la experiencia que sustenta nuestras vidas.
Those few words sum up the richness of every Christian vocation. The joy of knowing we are God's children. This is the experience that nourishes our lives, that seeks always to be a pleasing response to God's love. How important it is to renew this joy day by day. We need to ask for this joy and say, I'm a daughter of God.
Un camino privilegiado que tienen ustedes para renovar esta certeza es la vida de oración.
A privileged path that you have for renewing this conviction is a life of prayer,
la oración es el
both
núcleo de
communal
vida sagrada,
and individual.
Es el modo
this is the heart of your contemplative life
que sostiene nuestra fe.
And the means of cultivating the experience of love that sustains our faith. And indeed, as Mother Soledad rightly said, this is a prayer that is always missionary. This is a prayer that goes out.
Es la que logra unirse a los hermanos en las variadas circunstancias en que se encuentran.
Missionary prayer makes us one with our brothers and sisters in whatever situations they find themselves, and ask that love and hope will never fail them. This is what Saint Therese of the Child Jesus said. I understood that it is love alone which prompts the members of the Church to act, and if there is no love, neither would the apostles proclaim the gospel, nor would the martyrs spill their blood. I recognized clearly, and I was certain, that love subsumes in itself all vocations, that love is everything,
cada una de ustedes pueda decir.
Keep us in all times and places. In a word, that love is eternal. In the hearts of the church, who is my mother, I will be loved.
Pues un regalo de Dios, poder amar.
To be able to love is a gift from God.
Saber estar al lado del sufrimiento de tantos hermanos.
To be loved, this means being able to stand alongside the sufferings of so many of our brothers and sisters, and to say with the psalmist, in my distress I call upon the Lord answered me and set me free. In this way, your cloistered life can attain a missionary and a universal outreach and play a fundamental role in the life of the Church. You pray and intercede for our many brothers and sisters who are prisoners, migrants, refugees, and victims of persecution. Your prayers of intercession embrace the many families experiencing difficulties, the unemployed, the poor, the sick, and those struggling with addiction, to mention just a few of the more urgent situations. You are like those who brought the paralytic to the Lord for healing. Through your prayer, night and day, you bring before God the lives of so many of our brothers and sisters, who for various reasons cannot come to Him to experience His healing mercy, even as He patiently waits for them. By your prayer, you can heal the wounds of many.
Acercan al Señor la vida de muchos hermanos y hermanas que por diversas situaciones no pueden alcanzarlo para experimentar su misericordia sanadora, mientras que Él los espera para llenarlos de gracia. Por vuestra oración, ustedes curan las llagas de tantos hermanos. Por eso mismo, podemos afirmar
que la vida de clausura we can state that cloistered life neither closes nor shrinks our hearts, but rather widens them in our relationship with the Lord.
Por favor,
please, if you have your heart shrinked, look for help.
Que vuelva a respirar, que vuelva a ser un corazón grande. Además, las monjas encogidas son monjas que han perdido la fecundidad, que no son madres, se quejan de todo.
Nuns with a shrunk heart are not good mothers. They complain.
Siempre están buscando
and are always looking
para quejarse.
For something to complain.
La Santa Madre decía, ay de la monja que dice, hiciéronme sin razón. Me hicieron una injusticia.
The Holy Mother, as she said.
En el convento no hay lugar para los coleccionistas de injusticias.
In the monastery there's no room for nuns who collect unjust reasons.
La cruz fecunda.
We need a fruitful cross. A cross of love, the cross of unity.
El amor ensancha el corazón. Y por tanto, con el Señor, vamos adelante, porque Él nos hace capaz de sentir de un modo nuevo el dolor, el sufrimiento, la frustración, la desventura de tantos.
The Lord make us capable of feeling in a new way the pain, the suffering, the frustration, and the misfortune of so many of our brothers and sisters. May intercession for those in need be the hallmark of your prayer. And whenever possible, help them, not only by prayer, but also by a concrete service.
Respetando el silencio, en algunos momentos de locutorio pueden hacer tanto bien.
In your moments of silence, you can do a lot of good.
Que se hace en sus monasterios, sintoniza con el corazón de Jesús que implora al Padre para que todos seamos uno.
The prayer of supplication that takes place in your monasteries is attuned to the heart of Jesus, which pleads to the Father that we may all be one.
Que todos sean uno.
How much we need in unity in the Church.
Que los bautizados sean uno.
We need that the baptized be one.
Que los sacerdotes sean
that the priests be one.
Que los obispos sean uno.
That the bishops be one.
Hoy y siempre unidos en la fe, unidos por la esperanza.
Today and always, united in faith, united by hope, united by love, in the unity that wells up from our communion with Christ, who unites us to the Father in the Spirit and in the Eucharist, unites us with one another in that great mystery, which is the Church. I ask you, please, to pray constantly for unity in this beloved Church in Peru. Pray for the unity of the Church. Pray for the clergy, for the bishops, for the missionaries.
Es mentiroso. Y además es chismoso.
The devil is a liar.
Le encanta andar llevando de un lado para otro.
He loves to bring gossips back and forth.
Quiere que en la comunidad unas hablen mal de las otras.
The devil wants that in the community, others talk bad about others.
Esto lo dije muchas veces, así que me repito. ¿Saben lo que es la monja chismosa?
I want to remind you.
Terrorista.
You know what is a nun who lies? A nun who gossips? She's a terrorist. A worse than a terrorist. Why? Gossip is like a bomb.
You
throw the bomb, explodes, and you go back.
Sin chisme. Ya saben que el mejor remedio para no chismear, morderse la lengua.
The best remedy to avoid gossiping, by your tongue.
O sea, que no haya chismes en el convento.
We don't need gossip in the convents. Because that comes from the devil. He is a liar.
Y acuérdense de los terroristas de Ayacucho cuando tengan ganas de pasar un chisme. Esfuércense en la vida fraterna, haciendo que cada monasterio.
Strive to grow in the fraternal life, so that every monastery can be a beacon of light in the midst of disunity and division. This is possible. That all of that who comes to you may experience the charity the fraternal charity so essential to the consecrated life
and
so necessary in today's world and in our communities. When we live our vocation faithfully, our life becomes a proclamation of God's love. I ask you never to stop giving that witness. In the Church of the Discalced Carmelites Nazarenes, I readily recall the words of the great spiritual teacher, Saint Teresa of Jesus. If you lose your guide, who is the good Jesus, you will not get the journey right. For the same Lord says He is the way, the Lord also says He is the light, and that no one can come to the Father except through Him. Sisters, the Church needs you.
La Iglesia las necesita. Con su vida fiel, sean faros.
The Church needs you with your lives of fidelity.
Al único Señor que ofrece plenitud a
the Church needs you as lights, and that you keep pointing to the one who is the way and the truth and the life. Pray for the Church, for priests and bishops, for consecrated men and women, for families, for those who suffer, for those who harm others, for those who exploit their brothers and sisters. And do not forget, please, to pray for me.
Are now singing the responsory. With you, O Lord, is the source of life, and in your light we see light.
Dios Todopoderoso y Eterno, dirige nuestras acciones según tu voluntad.
O powerful, ever-living God, direct our steps in the way of your love, so that our whole life may be fragrant with all we do in the name of Jesus. The beloved Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Especialmente a los enfermos. Y también bendice los objetos de devoción que
our Holy Father will now impart his blessing and on the sisters here, especially on those who are sick and on all religious articles they carry.
Nuestro auxilio es el nombre del Señor. La bendición de Dios Todopoderoso, Padre, del Hijo y del Espíritu Santo, descienda sobre ustedes y permanezca para siempre.
Amén.
Bendigamos al Señor.
The contemplative religious who are present greeting our Holy Father. And our Holy Father now will greet the abbesses and the prioresses who are present. This brings to a conclusion the celebration of daytime prayer in the shrine of Señor de los Milagros, with our Holy Father presiding and with members of contemplative institutes present. At the conclusion of this moment of prayer, and after our Holy Father has finished greeting those present, our Holy Father will go by car to the Cathedral of Lima, and there he will spend some time in prayer before the relics of the Peruvian saints, after which he will meet the bishops of Peru. Later this afternoon, he will celebrate the liturgy and will depart after that for Rome. Here for Vatican News, I am Sister Bernadette, and thank you, Deacon Cesar. Laudetur Jesus Christus.